Cain is deified. The clans tell tales of him. Few know the truth. He was mortal once, as were we all. However, his contempt for humanity drove him to create me and my brethren. I am Raziel, firstborn of his lieutenants. I stood with Cain and my brethren at the dawn of the Empire. I have served him a millennium. Over time, we became less human and more divine. Cain would enter the state of change and emerge with a new gift. Some years after the Master, our evolution would follow, until I had the honor of surpassing my lord. Transgression, I earned a new kind of reward. Agony. There was only one possible outcome. Eternal damnation. I, Raziel, was to suffer the fate of traitors and weaklings, to burn forever in the bowels of the Lake of the Dead.
Cast him in.
Tumbling, burning with white-hot fire, I plunged into the depths of the abyss. Unspeakable pain, relentless agony. Time ceased to exist. Only this torture and a deepening hatred of the hypocrisy that damned me to this hell. An eternity passed, and my torment receded. Bringing me back from the precipice of madness. The descent had destroyed me, and yet I lived.
I know you, Raziel. You are worthy.
What madness is this? What pitiful form is this that I have come to inhabit? Death would be a release next to this travesty.
You did not survive the abyss, Raziel. I have only spared you from total dissolution.
I would choose oblivion over this existence.
The choice is not yours.
I am destroyed.
You are reborn. The birth of one of Cain's abominations traps the essence of life. It is this soul that animates the corpse you lived in. And that, Raziel, is the demise of Nazgoth. There is no balance. The souls of the dead remain trapped. I cannot spin them in the wheel of fate. They cannot complete their destinies. Redeem yourself. Or if you prefer, avenge yourself. Settle your dispute with Cain. Destroy him and your brethren. Free their souls and let the wheel of fate churn again. Use your hatred to weave their souls. I can make it possible. Become my soul weaver. My angel of death.
The old hunger has left me. I have no desire for blood.
You are changed. Your bloodthirst is replaced by a deeper need. You have become a devourer of souls. To sustain your strength, you must hunt the lost spirits of the underworld and consume the souls of your enemies. As you leap, and they will carry you across this chasm. are your conduit between the spectral and material realms. With their aid, you may gather matter and will yourself to become manifest in the physical world. This is taxing, however. Your strength must first be fully restored. You require no conduit to return to this plane. You may abandon your physical body at any time. Sustain your strength to prolong your manifestation in the physical world. If you fail to feed or absorb too many wounds, this fragile matter will dissolve. Many of your vampiric weaknesses. Immersion in water, while not fatal, will dissolve your physical body, forcing your return to the spirit world. Be aware that in the spectral realm, water has neither heft nor lift. It stands as thin as air. Children of your brother, Duma.
That's impossible. These foul, scuttling beasts could not be kin of our high blood.
Do you suppose that time stood still for you, Raziel? Much has changed since you passed from the world of men.
Weaknesses, having suffered them myself. Physical wounds are fleeting. Vampire's immortal flesh begins to close as soon as it is cleaved. Vampires need only fear those wounds that impale or inflame. Water scorches like acid, and fledglings are devastated by sunlight's touch. I would have to modify my tactics to suit my foes.
Unfettered from the flesh, a creature's soul fades swiftly into the spectral realm. Draw it in quickly, Raziel, or you will be compelled to follow. Even massive obstacles can be moved effortlessly.
sanctuary of the clans reduced to ruin. Beyond these walls lay the pillars of Nosgoth, the seat of Kane's empire. How humble it now appeared, collapsing into the dust of its former magnificence. And yet, I had only just emerged. In the instant between my execution and resurrection, centuries had apparently passed.
This world is wrecked with cataclysms. The earth strains to shrug off the pestilence of Kane's parasitic empire. The fate of this world was preordained in an instant by a solitary man. Unwilling to martyr himself to restore Nosgoth's balance, Kane condemned the world to the decay you see. In that moment, the unraveling began. Now it is nearly played out. Nosgoth teeters on the brink of collapse. Its fragile balance cannot hold.
Much of Nosgoth's landscape had changed. These cliffs gave me my bearings. My clan territory was to the west. I was anxious to see how my descendants had fared during the centuries of my absence. kin wiped from this world like excrement from a boot. I knew the hand that wrought this deed.
Thank you.
big racks of flesh. Their scent was vampiric. They gnawed upon their victim's carcass like dogs. Oh, the unmistakable marks of Melchior's clan. To what depths had our dynasty plummeted if these ghouls were the descendants of my high-born brother? Were they so debased as to recruit fledglings from the desiccated corpses here interred? Brother Melchior was made last, and therefore received the poorest portion of Cain's gift. Although immortal, his soul could not sustain the flesh, which retained much of its previous human frailty. This weakness, it seemed, was passed on to his offspring. Their fragile skins barely contained the underlying decay.
Oh!
These wraiths are vampire spirits, fettered too long in the spectral realm. When their vampire natures adapt to this plane, they become eaters of souls. Do not allow these spirits to re-inhabit their corpses.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Show yourself, creature.
Do you not recognize me, brother? Am I so changed?
Melkaya?
Yes, brother. You should have stayed where the Master sent you, Raziel. You will find Nosgoth less pleasant than you remember.
What has become of my clan? Answer me, little brother, or I will beat an answer from your horrid lips.
Everyone is afraid, sibling. You awake to a world of fear. These times of change are so unsettling. Do you think I feel no revulsion for this form? Do you believe for a moment that our lord would risk his empire upon an upstart inheritance?
Enough riddles. What are you saying?
You are the last to die.
Can I find Cain?
The Master is beyond your reach, Raziel. He makes himself known when he sees fit, not when commanded.
Elevated, Raziel, not reduced. Consuming Melkaya's soul has endowed you with a new gift. Insubstantial barriers such as these are no impediment to you in the spectral realm. Will yourself to pass through, and you shall. to the sanctuary of the clans, Raziel. Melkaya's soul has endowed you with the means to gain entry. Beware, however. This hollow derelict is abandoned, but not uninhabited. Empower you with elemental lore. Each spell exacts a sacrifice of energy, however. Use them sparingly and wisely.
Yeah.
With Melkaya's gift, your way is opened. Return to the seat of Cain's ill-omened empire. Its sterile silence has secrets yet to unveil.
Thank you. Come on.